This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. A protagonist from ancient Greek protagonistes, meaning player of the first part, chief actor, is the main character in any story, such as a literary work or drama. The protagonist is at the center of the story, should be making the difficult choices and key decisions, and should be experiencing the consequences of those decisions. The protagonist can affect the main character's decisions. The protagonist should be propelling the story forward. If a story contains a subplot, or is a narrative that is made up of several stories, then there may be a character who is interpreted as the protagonist of each subplot or individual story. The word protagonist is used notably in stories and forms of literature and culture that contain stories, which would include dramas, novels, operas and films. In those forms, the protagonist may simply be the leading actor, or the principal character in the story. More formally, the protagonist, while still defined as a leading character, may also be defined as the character whose fate is most closely followed by the reader or audience, and who is opposed by a character known as the antagonist. The antagonist will provide obstacles and complications and create conflict that test the protagonist, thus revealing the strengths and weaknesses of their character. Ancient Greece. The earliest known examples of protagonist are dated back to ancient Greece. At first, performances involved merely dancing and recitation by the chorus, but then in Poetics, Aristotle describes how a poet named Thespis introduced the idea of having one actor step out and engage in a dialogue with the chorus. This was the invention of tragedy, which occurred about 536 BC. Then the poet Aeschylus, in his plays, introduced a second actor, inventing the idea of dialogue between two characters. Sophocles then wrote plays that required a third actor. Examples: Euripides' play, Hippolytus, may be considered to have two protagonists. The protagonist of the first half is Phaedra, until she dies, then her stepson. The title character, Hippolytus, has the dominant role in the second half. In Ibsen's play, The Master Builder, the protagonist is the architect Hallvard Solness. The young woman, Hilda Wangle, whose actions lead to the death of Solness, is the antagonist. In Shakespeare's play, Romeo and Juliet, Romeo is the protagonist. He is actively in pursuit of his relationship with Juliet, and the audience is invested in that story. The character of Tybalt opposes Romeo's desires. He is the antagonist. In Shakespeare's play, Hamlet, Prince Hamlet, who seeks revenge for the murder of his father, is the protagonist. The antagonist would be the character who most opposes Hamlet. Claudius in the novel, The Catcher in the Rye, the character Holden Caulfield is the protagonist. He is the leading character, and the reader is invested in his story. Sometimes, a work will have a false protagonist, who may seem to be the protagonist, but then may disappear unexpectedly. The character Marion in Alfred Hitchcock's film Psycho 1960 is an example. A novel that contains a number of narratives may have a number of protagonists. Alexander Solzhenitsyn's The First Circle, for example, depicts a variety of characters imprisoned and living in a gulag camp. Leo Tolstoy's War and Peace depicts 15 major characters involved in or affected by war. References: Carat Protagonistes, Henry George Liddell, Robert Scott, A Greek-English Lexicon, on Perseus Digital Library. Carat Duncan, Stephen A. Guide to Screenwriting Success, Writing for Film and Television. Roman of Useful Knowledge, Society for the Diffusion of Useful Knowledge, London, 1840, page 306. Carat Encyclopædia Britannica Online. Carat Aristotle Poetics, Oxford University Press, January 20, 2013, ISBN 978-0199608362. Carat Packard, William, The Art of the Playwright. Thunder's Mouth Press, 1997, ISBN 1-56025-117-4. Carat Story, Ian Allen, Arlene A. Guy to Ancient Greek Drama. John Wiley, May 1, 1991, ISBN 978-0316769488. Carat Kolker, Robert Philip. Alfred Hitchcock's Psycho, A Casebook. Oxford University Press, 2004, ISBN 9780195169195. Carat The Solzhenitsyn Reader, New and Essential Writings, 1947-2005, Alexander Solzhenitsyn, Edward E. Erickson Jr., Daniel J. Mahoney. Carat Moser, Charles, 1992, Encyclopedia of Russian Literature, Cambridge University Press, pp. 298-300. VE Narrative. Character Antagonist, Antihero, Archenemy. Character Arc. Characters Voice. Characterization Deuteragonist. False protagonist focal character foil protagonist stock character supporting character tritagonist narrator plot action backstory cliché climax cliffhanger conflict deus ex machina dialogue dramatic structure. Exposition you catastrophe foreshadowing flashback flash forward framing device frame story in medias res pace plot device plot twist poetic justice reveal self-fulfilling prophecy subplot trope kishotenketsu setting. Backstory utopia dystopia alternate history fictional location city country universe theme leitmotif metaphor moral motif irony style allegory bathos diction. Figure of speech imagery narrative technique narration stylistic device suspension of disbelief symbolism tone mode mood structure linear narrative interactive narration nonlinear narrative films television series types of fiction with multiple endings form. Epic fable fablio fairy tale folktale flash fiction legend novella novel parable play poem screenplay short story list of narrative forms genre action fiction adventure. Comic crime docufiction epistolary erotic fiction fantasy gothic historical horror magic realism mystery nautical paranoid philosophical picaresque political psychological. Romance saga satire science speculative superhero thriller urban western list of writing genres narrator first person second person third person multiple narrators stream of unconsciousness unreliable. Tense past present future related audience author creative nonfiction fiction writing literary theory literary science narratology monomyth rhetoric screenwriting storytelling literature portal authority control. GND, 4,125,655-4.